Our second speaker this morning is Mike Slattery. In May of this year, the only car that Mike's family had was stolen. Mike and his wife, Beth, have been looking for a replacement car ever since. They have yet to find an appropriate vehicle to replace the car that they lost. Why does it take a such long period of time to make a decision on what to buy? Mike believes that it may be because of all the choices that are out there. Or maybe it could be that any decision creates a feeling that the decision could be wrong. Please welcome with me our second speaker, Mike Slattery. There's no such thing as a right or wrong decision. Mike Slattery.
In the 1970s, Chrysler Corporation was dead and dying. Lee Iacocca came in and brought that company up to where it is today. When asked how he did it, he said, "I can sum that up in one word: decisiveness. Decisiveness, that's what makes a good manager." I want to point out that when he made that statement, he didn't say that the decisions had to be right or wrong. He just said, you need to make the decision. You have to be decisive. But we as a society have been brought up to believe that our decisions, as I mentioned in my introduction, could be right or wrong. Why is that? Well, I believe the reason that is because of our upbringing in the Christian Judeo thought of it is right or it is wrong. And so that is our mental attitude about instances that happen in our life. But when we make a decision, that helps bring forth to us indecision. Why should we be worried whether our decision is right or wrong? Because it's what? Our decision. So if it's our decision, then we have to make it right. On December 7th, 1942, Hirohito, the Emperor of Japan, decided to bomb Pearl Harbor. He thought that was the right decision for his country, his people, and his army. Whoa! We didn't think that was right. We thought it was wrong. And at that point, we made a decision to go to war against Japan. And from that decision, the United States made it right. We won. Might be a bit dispute on that right now as to who won the war, but in any case, we won the war. A reporter once asked a very successful hedge fund manager, "How did you get to be so successful?" Two words, right decision. The reporter said, "How did you make the right decision?" He said, "Experience." The reporter said, "How do you get the experience?" Wrong decisions. Mm-hmm. So again, we're talking about right or wrong, but the fact is there is no right or wrong. He became successful thinking that he had made the right decisions from his experience, and his experience was things that didn't work. So perhaps we ought to think about our decisions as what works and what doesn't. So let's think about some of the things we can do that would make a decision. First of all, get as much information as possible that you can get about what you're going to decide on. Now, in my case, 3 months We've looked, I think, at every make, model of cars that are in existence. We haven't made a decision yet. Our rental bill keeps going up and up and up and up. I told Beth yesterday, I said, well, you know, for what we've paid for this rental car so far, we could have had 5 payments on a brand new car. And it's based on the fear of, is our decision going to be right or wrong? I keep telling her, it doesn't matter. When you get in that car and start the engine, drive down the road and get to where you're going, not even in your mind. Not even in your mind. So that's the first of all. Get as much information as you can. Second of all, examine the pros and cons of your decision. Now that's easy, because there's a thing called a Ben Franklin spreadsheet. And that's what you do. You take on one side all the reasons why you should do what you're going to do. On the other side, say all the reasons why you don't want to do what you want to do. Whichever has the longest list, do it. So if it's a pro, go for it. If it's a con, don't do it. Make another decision. Third thing you should do is go for the pros or cons. Go for the pros. Use your gut feeling. And the reason I say use your gut feeling is because that's the emotion. That's the emotion that's going to make that decision right. Like I mentioned in the beginning of my speech here, the United States decided they were going to win the war. Man, they brought in everything. In fact, I can't remember the Japanese admiral that said, we have awakened a sleeping giant. And that's what the gut feeling does when we make a decision. Now, at this point in time, I want you to think. I want you to make a decision. I'm going to give you a scenario. You're in Florida. You're in Mar-a-Lago. And there is great chaos going on all around you. Hurricanes, floods, severe winds, huge masses of houses, and people are being swept away in the water. And you're a photographer. And you now have a chance to make a photograph of this, and you can bring it to the public. And as you're standing there, you're looking and you see a man surviving, trying to get out of the mud and the water that's sweeping them down. So you get closer and you see it's Donald Trump. So here you have to make a decision as a photographer. Do you want to reach out and save him? Or do you want to take a photograph of a dying, powerful man? And the decision is this. Did you use colored film or black and white? Just remember, there's no such thing as a right or wrong decision. Just make the decision. Mr. Toastman.